this week's episode, I'm going to take a look at the web version of Microsoft Word. And if you think it hasn't changed much, well, think again. There are five amazing features that you definitely gotta know. Stay tuned and you'll find out. Greetings, fellow YouTubers. How are you? Welcome to the channel. Andy here. This week, I'm on site, as you can see, in Manchester. And I was looking through Microsoft 365, and I thought, you know, something I've never done a video on is Microsoft Word. And I thought, let me take a closer look at it. And you're probably thinking, oh, it's the usual word processor that is actually quite old now. It's been around for almost 30-odd years. But it's had quite a revolutionary makeover in recent years. And so on this week's episode, I'm going to show you my top five amazing features that I'll bet you didn't even know about. And these are features that will make you just so much more productive. So stay tuned. I got some really cool stuff planned ahead. Now, if you haven't subscribed to the channel, I would love you to come on board. So bump that subscribe button up there, ring that notification bell, and you'll be notified about any new videos and postings. And if you've got questions on this or any of my other videos, as always, get those down below. Now, I also, as you know, I run a Patreon site. So if you want access to full courses, monthly Zoom calls, and so much more, then please sign up there for more details. So I think we'll step in, take a look at these top five features in Microsoft Word that I'll bet you didn't even know about. Check it out. So my first demo, what I'm going to do is I'm in here in Microsoft 365. I'm going to come in and I'm going to go into OneDrive. And here in OneDrive, you can see I've got a number of documents here. I've got a number of reports. In addition, I can also go into my files and let's have a look at what I've got. So you can see in here, I've got an annual financial report. So I can go into the financial report and you can see it's got some financials in, it's got some graphs and charts. Now, wouldn't it be cool if you could transform this into a PowerPoint presentation? Well, check it out. Now you can. So I click on File. I'm simply going to go into Export. And we've got this new feature here where you can now export the document either directly as a web page. So it could be, for example, interactive with your team. You can also export it to PowerPoint. Oh, cool. And that's currently in preview. And you can even send the document to your Kindle. So, hey, I'm going to go ahead and create a PowerPoint presentation. So first up, you're presented with a number of templates. And you can see here, you know, this one looks pretty cool. I'm going to go with that one. So let's go ahead and let's see what we get. Now, in this presentation, it's only a two-page document, so I'm sure you get the idea. But first up, I'm going to go here into PowerPoint and check it out. So here we have the financial report. And you can see if you don't like the design that it's suggested, we have this designer feature here in PowerPoint. So I can just simply click onto the option of my choice. And likewise, I can come in here. I can add in a title here. And I can call this, let's say, my yearly income. And I'll call it my yearly income report. And you can see, again, it provides us with a fairly decent demo. Again, I can edit this. I can change any of this if I want to. And you can see, again, it provides us with some options. So you might want to, yeah, I want to make it look a little bit nicer or maybe a little bit snazzier. And you can add a picture in or however you want to set it up. But the fact is that you get these really nice kind of setups here. So from a document, just with a couple of clicks, you've created a PowerPoint presentation. Very nice. So for my number two offering, I want to show you again one of my really favorite features. As you can see, I'm an author, by the way. I write novels, and this is a little synopsis of my book, The Seventh Day. And looking at this on page, it's not the most exciting, really, is it? Well, there's a really nice feature to help your writing skills. So you can see here, for example, it's making some suggestions on things like formatting, or here you can see again it's making a suggestion, and I can go in, I can have a look at those suggestions if I want to. Now, the other thing that's really good, especially for authors, is the fact that I can come into the editor function up here. And it, with the editor function, you can see it gives me an editor score. So in terms of spelling, in terms of grammar, and again, acronyms, things like, you know, the formality of the document. So essentially you can see here that it's classing it as formal writing. But again, I could change it if I want to. I could say, you know, if this was casual, what kind of impact would it be? So in terms of casual, you see it's not picking up as many errors. And likewise, professional, it might make some options. So again, I can click into the suggestion. I can open that suggestion. And you can see here it's making some changes. So because of his discovery, instead of as a consequence of his discovery. So again, I might take that suggestion and pop that in. So again, you can see it improves your overall writing score. From an editor perspective, it's actually really, really useful, because, you know, we all make potential mistakes, of course. Now, in addition to that particular tool, another tool that you should definitely take a look at, again, is the formatting. So we have a tool here called the Designer tool. And this, you'll find this in all Microsoft versions of their applications. So in Word, Excel, PowerPoint, and so on. And you can either click on the drop-down arrow, you can go into Designer, or you can basically hide those suggestions. So I'm thinking, you know, it's a pretty drab document. I might want to improve it a little bit. So there are some improvements, some suggestions here that it will make you. And you think, yeah, okay, you know, this one looks kind of nice. So I can click onto that, and you can see it improves the look and feel. So you can change the format, you can change the look of it, and you pretty much get to a point that you're happy with. So once you're happy, again, I can close that Designer, and now you can see it's looking actually not too bad. Now, the other thing that you might want to do is you might want to do some add-ins. So again, here in the add-ins, one of the nice things is there is a whole bunch of different add-ins for Microsoft 365. And you can see you can even bring in ChatGPT. So if you're not using Enterprise, Bing Chat, or whatever it's called now, Copilot for Microsoft 365, which you might find a tad expensive, you can still bring in the likes of things like ChatGPT. Now, the only issues with bringing in that, of course, is that if you're going to save it, anything that you write here could potentially be shared publicly. So again, just be careful of that. Now, another thing that I want to mention is sensitivity labels. So in Microsoft 365, let me just flip over here, actually. I'm going to come into the admin center here in Microsoft 365. And from an administrator perspective, compliance is super important. So I can come into the compliance center. And even if you've got a business premium version, you can still take advantage of this. So in here, I can scroll down and we have this feature called information protection. And information protection allows me to protect my data. So I can just flip into this. I'm going to go into labels. So you can see here what I've done is I've gone and created a number of what we call sensitivity labels. I'm in Manchester today, so I can go in and I can edit this label if I want to. So I can walk you through it. So you can see I can choose a color for the label. I've called it Manchester Confidential. And I've said, hey, I want to protect files, emails, meetings. You can even do group and team access as well. I've not got that switched on at the moment. So I'll click on next. And I've decided I want to encrypt my data, and I also want to add in headers and footers with the word, for example, confidential. So I can put in that and I can say, yep, yeah, I want to assign permissions. I might not want my users to gain access to the content when it's not online or when it's not offline, for example. So you don't want people storing sensitive information, for example, on a laptop. You might just want to be able to access it through the cloud. You can also assign permissions to that. So for example, I've said, yeah, I want to provide co-author permissions. And you can see I've gone ahead and added a footer to my document. So I've done that and I've clicked on that and I've basically created my label. So again, I've just saved the label. And what I've done is I've now created a label policy. And with a label policy, you can determine which groups or which users are going to get access to that label. So for that, if I come down into label policies, you can see I've created a couple of label policies. So if I just go into that policy, I can now go in and edit that policy, for example. And you can see I've added, you can add in different labels. And basically here, I've just set that up so that you can allow the users to choose their own label. Now, if you want to see more about this, I've actually done videos on this previously in the past. So go ahead and check out my Microsoft Purview playlist and its information protection. You'll get lots of details about it. So having created those labels, I'm now going to come back here. And of course, I can now go back into my files in my document. And what do we have here? Well, check it out. My next feature is up here on the toolbar, and this is the sensitivity label. And sure enough, if I click into here, you can now see that all my sensitivity labels are here. Now, it does take a little while, it can take up to an hour for the labels to publish, but sure enough, you can now see I've got a label called Microsoft, or Manchester rather, confidential. So my document is now confidential and it prevents it from being leaked outside the company. So again, very, very cool. So again, just a few small, really, really useful features. Now, while I'm here, the other thing that I want to do is if I just say, hey, I want to go ahead and create a new document here. So I'm going to create another new document. You can see this is in dark mode. You can change this if you want to. One of my favorite features, though, is we all know how voice control works. So voice control allows us to, again, use dictation. So I can say, yeah, I want to, first of all, select the options for dictation. You can, there's a little gear icon here. So I'm going to go ahead, I'm going to say, yes, I want to do a dictation and I want to start typing. So it's going to say, am I going to allow this? Yes, I am. Okay, so I'm going to allow the microphone. And now that I've done that, you can, if you have multiple options or multiple microphones, you can configure it. You can also configure the volume levels and so on. So when you're ready, again, you get a nice help page here. So again, when you're ready, I can just start typing. And as I start typing, you can see it starts to edit the text. And at any point, you can change it. And you can see as I start talking, you can see that it will add in full stops. It's not perfect, but it does a pretty good job. Full stop. Select paragraph. Change font color to red. How cool is that? So by using simple dictation, not only can you create your text, but you can also edit it, select it, change colors and formats. This is a fantastic, not just an accessibility option, but also a super useful feature in Microsoft Word. So the final part here that I want to show you, just some tips and tricks that, again, you may not be aware about. So as you can see up here, there is a share option here. So this is really nice. I can share this document without even going into my OneDrive folder. I can copy the link and give a direct copy or the link to somebody within my company. And I can even manage access to the document here as well. So we have a couple of options. You can see the people who are in your company. So I can go ahead and just start sharing with this. So I can simply say, hey, you know, I want to add someone. So I've got a user here called Alan. And if I type in the word Alan, hopefully he will come out. Or actually, I'll tell you what, I'll make it Adele. So Adele, I'm going to share this document with Adele. And you can specify, can the user edit? Can they view? And with depending on the version that you're using, I don't want the user to be able to download this document. So yes, they can edit it. And this is cool because if you share a document with multiple users, then multiple editors can work on the document at the same time, which is really nice. So I'm happy with this. And I'm going to say, you know, I want Adele to be able to review it, but not do anything else. And I can type in a little message here to Adele. So I can just say, Adele, you want to just give me a quick review of this document? I can send her the link, or I can just send her it through an invitation. So you can see now that I've added Adele in, I am reviewing it, and you can see that the document is locked. So again, I'm going to share this document out. I'm going to send her that invitation. So she will now add access to that document. Now, at any point using that shared menu and the manage access, I can see exactly who's got access, what level of access the user has got. I can also see which groups and also which links are currently being shared. And you can see, look, there's my sensitivity label that I had previously. So at any point, I can stop sharing this document if I want to. And again, I can go ahead and grant access to another user as well. So the last thing that I want to show you is I'm going to pop over here onto the file tab, and I'm going to come into info. And I have a couple of options here. You can open it up in Microsoft Word, unless, of course, you set the permission to where they can't download a copy. You can protect the document. And I love this. This is version history. So within Microsoft Office, all of Microsoft Office applications, you've got a previous version of any documents that you've been working on. So this is really useful. So if you make a mistake, especially in a PowerPoint presentation, or you delete a number of slides, don't worry. You can go back, and at any point, you can then just restore this. So again, I can click onto this and restore this back to a previous version. I love that feature. I think it's really, really super useful. So there you have it, my super cool top 5 features in Microsoft Word Online. So even if you're using the free version of 365 or you're using one of the paid versions, you're all going to get those same amazing features. Now, of course, there are features that come with the Mac and the Windows version, but I'm finding that the cloud version is the version that Microsoft are really paying a lot of attention to. And it's a feature that's got so many amazing features. Now, thanks so much for joining me this week. I hope you've enjoyed it. And if you did, give me a thumbs up. I really do appreciate it. And if you've not subscribed, hit that subscribe button, ring that bell, and come and join my great learning community. Okay, that's it for this time. You stay safe. I'll see you soon. Hey, thanks so much for dropping by today. Here's a couple of videos that you may enjoy. And while you're here, go ahead, click on the subscribe button, and you won't miss out.